Here's a little update on the Rocket Mass heater project. I decided to make a few changes to the feed tube, so I dug out the entire area and removed the tube. Even after letting the system cool for a day, the sand from around the heater was still steaming hot. On the original layout, I didn't bother to install an ash pit. On the long burns, the cinders and ash would accumulate too quickly in the burn chamber and eventually choke the system. I modified the feed tube so that there was an ash pit. This allowed for the longer burns, but I still had to let the system burn out before removing the ash. I installed a deeper ash pit and a second pit. I then made up a grate for the wood to sit on. The grate also went in front of the burn tunnel so that the cinders wouldn't fall into the tunnel. As the wood burns, the larger cinders stay on top of the grate while the ash will work its way into the cleanout pit. I just need to remove the cover and scrape the ash out of the area. This is part of the feed tube where the ash cleanout is. The grate sits above the cleanout and in front of the burn tunnel. The cleanout pit is large enough so I can get some kind of hoe in there to scrape out the ash. Or, if I'm more daring, my arm will fit in all the way. The pit raises to the floor grade and will have a cover to prevent the air from improperly drafting the system the wrong way. With some background light shining into the pit, you can see how the grate fits into place. Here is the heater shortly after I started it and how the grate is protecting the tunnel from any cinders. Just for fun, here is a time-lapse video of a burn that lasted about 30 minutes. Thanks for watching!